transsexual contemplative prayer, vocalized because we have made sound. Those of you who want the gift, that closing your mouth, Holy Spirit cannot move. You need to move your tongue, you need to move your mouth. Okay, people say, okay, I want tongue, and they don't do anything. It's not gonna come. It is not conceptual because you don't understand. It's like child babbling. And there was a great thing about this priest from Uganda. He was very discouraged. He was thinking about leaving his priesthood. He went to one of these parish, the after mass, everybody's gathered together and praying in tongues. He was just listening very carefully, and there was a lady behind him saying things in his own native language, the Uganda native language. And she was a Caucasian white lady. So he looked at her and he said, have you been to Uganda and have you learned our language? And he was, what language? So sometimes those languages. I know this beautiful Hispanic sister, she prayed in tongues in perfect Vietnamese. Yeah. And then there's another person seeking religious vocation, and she was not sure, back and forth, Shiraj and I, and she went to a conference, and there was a person praying in tongues, and she heard it. When she prayed in tongues, she heard God's message that you do have vocation to religious. Now she's one of the Mother Superior. So God works in very mysterious ways. It is the language, prayer, never offending God, because it's the Holy Spirit praying within us. So this prayer straight goes to the heaven and always in the line of the will of God. That's why it is so powerful. Then another one is interpretation of tongues. When somebody in tongues shout out and prophesies in prayer meeting, and there's supposed to be other person interpreting so that we can understand what it means. So these are the worst gifts. What are the three worst gifts? I'm going to check your short-term memory now. Gift of prophecy. Interpretation of tongues. Very good. Your pass. Now, then revelation, we have a power gifts. This power gifts, has first one has to be miracle. Direct intervention of God is supernatural. So we see that John 11:43, Jesus raised Lazarus from the tomb. Right? That's the miracle. And Mark 6:39, multiplication of loaves and fishes. Jesus fed 5,000 with 5 loaves and 2 fishes. That's the miracle. We still have other miracles, signs and wonders. People dramatically healed, blind see, lame walk. There was another miracle story that the person was testifying, the praying for cerebral palsy on the wheelchair. So she was sharing that she witnessed that. And all of a sudden there was some kind of commotion on the back. And find out there was a little girl who was cerebral palsy brought in the wheelchair. She stood up and walked forward by listening to that exhortation and testimony. So that's the power of miracle. And we have this gift of faith. Charismatic, expectant faith. That's what we need. Hebrews 11:1. Confidence that our prayer will be answered. The faith is a good example in the Acts of Apostles, chapter 3:1, when Peter and John, 3 o'clock, they went to pray at the beautiful gate, and they saw a man was born from the cripple. So Peter looked at him, and he felt he has a faith. He looked at him and said, neither I have silver nor gold, but in the name of Jesus, rise and walk. He stood up and walked. That's the faith. It's the faith-activating movement of Holy Spirit. And we have gift of healing. This healing is very ordinary and common. There's physical healing, emotional, spiritual healing. And I pray that all of you become the instrument for healing, because God can use anybody. And there is a revelation gift. So what are those three power gifts? Yes. Miracle, faith, and healing. There are three revelation gifts. Has to do with word of wisdom. We see the example from Solomon, you know, two women debating a child, and the Solomon king had this wisdom from on high. He asked God to give him wisdom. Let's divide his child. So that's how he discerned who was the true mother. A word of knowledge. This word of knowledge inspired revelation from God, spoken by an individual. It is sharing the truth, a fact, or understanding of truth. And the Holy Spirit wishes to reveal this to. So whenever we go to large gathering, people with a word of knowledge, without knowing anything else, and they say, there are people with blind, Lord is healing you, they get healed, right? There are people that you really worry about, you know, this and that, and God is helping you, and those of you who are contemplating suicide, or really want to stop that and come to me. So that's the word of knowledge. At this convention, just, you know, 2 weeks ago, when I prayed for, generally praying for people who are contemplating suicidal ideation, having suicidal wishes, to me, we discovered that with the power of Christ. So I finished the prayer, I went down just to the aisle to help out prayer teams at the mega healing. One gentleman came to me in tears, and he said, you know, like before you said the prayer, I was very suicidal. But after receiving the prayer, I got totally healed. I don't feel that anymore. And he was like hugging me. I have to go there. But he was continuing hugging me. He was so attached by the Spirit. So that's the example. And we have, lastly, discernment of the Spirit. What are we discerning? We are discerning what's happening right now. Does it have origin? Is it human spirit, or evil spirit, or Holy Spirit? We need to discern that this is the gift of discernment. 1 Thessalonians 5:21-22. Test everything and retain what is good. So this is the gift of discernment. This gift of discernment is very important. So we need to discern, this is a prophecy really from God? Or is this, discern the will of God? Discern, is this activity, origin, and evil spirit? Or is this a human? Sometimes human spirit can be very loving and sound nice, but it may not be the Holy Spirit. So these are the things we gotta be very sensitive. How are you going to be sensitive? By listening to the voice of the Holy Spirit. How? In silence, in contemplation, in prayer, in deep intimacy. Contemplation is looking at Jesus with love and receive His love. So exchange His love like we are transformed. That's as simple as that is. And then there are other gifts of service. There are gifts like help, hospitality, giving, administration, service, and mercy. So you see why you need these gifts? Because God wants to advance His kingdom on earth. And He needs each and every one of us. We can't do it, as He said, our own power. We need God's power, and this carries us of free gifts. God wants always give us gifts, free gifts. We receive it, but in the baptism of the Holy Spirit is receiving these gifts and these unused gifts, never opened boxes.